Good evening, everybody. This is Doc Stout, back with a little bit more Rogue Legacy. It's been a couple days since I've streamed this, and I've gotten a little bit further in-game. We're going to try some New Game Plus. I actually dropped the last boss this morning, so going to get to see what it looks like after the final boss is defeated, and everything gets just a little bit more difficult. Let's get in game here. Got a shiny new intro screen with a crown and all sorts of bright colors. Continue your quest plus. Alrighty. Looks like I just got an achievement for logging on. I'm not even sure what that was. I only have 500 coins, so it looks like we're going straight into the dungeon. Building the castle. I've got a Grace Rune on right now, because right after beating the game, I came in here without one on, and just kind of got destroyed. Grace Rune will level down all of the enemies. Which doesn't help if you cannot see in 2D, and fail to turn around. Whew. Okay. Looks like this is one of the characters with, I forget what they called it in the demo, they called it Tourette's. Let's take a look at our character card here. Coprolalia and Stereo Blind. Stereo Blind is what's given us the Paper Mario effect whenever somebody turns. Oof. Gotta be better than that in New Game Plus. I might try to take down the eyeball boss again. I guess you get stats every time you beat a boss in New Game Plus. But if not, just get some gold and grind up a little bit. I actually found the second-to-last boss before you actually get into the throne room to be the easiest of the five bosses in the game. Two-shot him. Oof. I like how the Coprolalia guy swears every time he gets hit. Just got a little bit more new gear as well. Well, there's the boss room. Let's see if we can't get a few more coins. 3,600 is enough to buy an upgrade if we die here. Ah, that would have been a smart move if I'd managed to get through that without taking any damage. Because I think I'm going to want to full hit points or as close to it as I can before I take on the boss. $5,140, I've definitely got enough for an upgrade. Man, I'm just tempted to go for it. Yeah, going back there is not going to do anything. Let's do it. The Gatekeeper Kidir. I can't remember if the first time I defeated this boss in normal game, if I did it on stream or not. Be nice to have a little bit of extra invulnerability time if I'm just gonna stand here and bang away at him. Sweet! That was pretty easy. Thank goodness for that Rune of Grace making this comically easier than it's supposed to be. Stat points. Plus one strength, plus five magic points, plus five hit points. Alright. That's permanently unlocked until we have to go to New Game Plus Plus. Oof. I forget how many pluses. I think game will go up to New Game Plus 7 before it stops getting any harder. And death is a virtual certainty at this point. That's okay, we got all sorts of stuff. That's what the best role-playing games are about, right? Getting stuff. Might be able to survive another room or two. 56 hit points out of 660. Ooh, I'm not gonna survive long if I stay in there, though. Oh, boy. Well, that sucked. Lady Stephanie the Fifth has been slain by a spike trap. Alright, new air. Let's, real quickly, when we're choosing our air, I want to do a quick alt-tab look in the chat. Oh, hello, Mystery Machine SA. Yeah, this game does get more difficult for a long time, but I think it's New Game Plus 7 or New Game Plus 10, where you can keep getting additional pluses, but the enemies actually level past getting any more difficult. I could be wrong on that, though. It's just something I saw in the forums. After all, I'm only at New Game Plus 1. We've got Charlotte the Fifth, the Dragon, Hokage, and I do not like Vertigo characters. We're going to reroll our kids. Another Hokage, another upside-down dragon. These are... Oh, yeah, we'll go for a Barbarian Queen. I'm going to be boring. Let's finish off Haggle. And did I leave myself enough to buy anything real? Get a few more hit points. I don't think I... No, I wasn't in there nearly long enough to get any runes. Yes, so we only lose 70% of our money now. I think after just a little bit more grinding, I'll take off the Grace Rune and see what this looks like at full strength. It was catastrophically overwhelming right after I got into New Game Plus. If I keep playing like this, it's going to continue to be. Oh! Eyeball shot right through the walls. Maybe aggroing the painting was not a good idea. I actually find there are a lot of similarities between this game and Dark Souls, which is another one that I stream regularly. Apologies if I'm not responding to chat in real time. I have to alt-tab because I don't have the laptop set up tonight. Alrighty. Sweet. Oof. Okay, yeah. One of the similarities, obviously, between this and Dark Souls is if you are not careful and don't observe enemy attack patterns, you just get schooled. I think this game, in many cases, is slightly more forgiving than Dark Souls is, though. Especially on New Game Mode. There was one boss on regular game where I actually had to sort of cheese them. There was only one one class, or child class and spell that I could actually beat them with. It was the Ponce de Leon. I had to use a spell sword with the fire shield. It was the only combination I could hope to beat the boss with. Although I have heard that the Barbarian King's shout actually drives the fires away. So if I may try that with a Barbarian as well for New Game Plus. Yeah, I'm starting to get thinking that so long as I can stop making stupid mistakes, I might be able to take the Grace Rune off and see how it goes. Get the extra money bump. Nope. Not playing the suckers game. Or I could maybe get a look in and see how bad the forest is with a Grace Rune. Oof. My spell axe, probably should have just used one. Oops. I was thinking I was off that. Barbarian does not need food yet. Alright. Oh. Well, if I keep doing stupid stuff like that, though. Sweet. Oh. Alrighty. Move forward a little bit here. I think one of the trickiest things for me was to keep straight which guys could shoot through walls, which guys could move through walls, and which guys could not. In the hairier rooms, you just gotta prioritize your threats a little bit. Make sure anything that can shoot through a wall is taken care of first. Especially things that can track you a little bit. Oof. Spent much of the day wanting to get back to this. Preparing for tomorrow's podcast with the guys with 40 going on 14. Doing our Transformers episode tomorrow, so I had to watch quite a bit of Transformers cartoons. It doesn't sound like a particularly rough way to spend a day, but the Transformers Prime was actually pretty bad. I'm not going to be able to go up through there. No, not going to try the Maya. Oops. I will, at some point, be doing some co-op in either Saints Row 3 or Saints Row 4 with one of the guys from the show, though. So there is that. Alright. Sweet. I don't think that I'm going to have the second boss as a target for tonight, especially considering, at least in regular game, I was streaming when I beat that second boss the first time. I will for sure attempt to stream my kill for Ponce in New Game Plus, though. Oh, that room looks like a minor nightmare. Good shot for the axe, though. Yeah, it took way more of my health than it should have. 5690, that's still some sort of stat upgrade, so this run's not going to be a waste. Gonna have to sharpen my skills a little bit if I'm going to take off that Grace Rune. Feels like training wheels. Welcome any new viewers tonight. I'm not keeping a real close eye on chat tonight, but I suppose I should start. I will, for my next Dark Souls stream, I will probably be going back to leveling Zim the Thief in preparation to invade. And the next time I do that in a primetime hour, I will make sure that I have a second screen up for chat. This is just a quick one for tonight. Blow off some watching bad cartoons related stress. No, first world problems. Wonder if that achievement I got when we first came in, I never did get a look at what that was, if that was the having played for 20 hours achievement. Oh my god, that looks like a nightmare. Well, it's bad, but... I'm not dead yet. Actually, the enemies seem pretty close to scaling and level to what they were in the castle without the Grace Rune. I forgot I'm nearsighted. Oh, jeez. Oof, okay. That's a bad room. 12 hit points left. Oh! Double jumped at the wrong time. That's a bad way to lose a life. Lady Teresa the Ninth slipped and was impaled by spikes. That's not a bad little collection of dead guys, though. Okay, I'm not a big fan of dragons or Hokages or Archmages, so we're going to reroll the kids. Spellsword with the Chakram, Gigantic Paladin. Or Stereo Blind Hokage. Well, that's tough. I think I'm gonna go with a Gigantic Paladin. Play Lady Blair the 12th. Before I raise anything here, I want to take a look and make sure I've actually got my best gear equipped. That's straight stat upgrades for 10 more weight. Let's unlock that. Dragon Helm for 2400 and see if I can afford the... I'm pretty sure I can afford the extra weight. Yeah. Do I have enough left over for anything significant? I could just buy more hit points. Alright, let's put on the new helm and see if I'm jumping over my skis here. Where's our Grace Rune? Alright, let's take off the Grace Rune and throw on a Bounty Rune. See how bad this is. Worst comes to worst, I can take the, put the Grace Rune back on and grind just a little bit more so I hit a little harder. Oof. Downside to Gigantism. It's AoE attacks. Alright. Okay. Daggers are not very useful here. Sweet. I'd love to call that skill, but that dodge was all luck. See? If I were skilled, I would have dodged that one. Oh god, nope, nope, nope. Try that again. Oh, what the hell is this? I suppose I could... yeah. Let's pray for assistance. Hermes Boots. I'm not sure what that does. It makes me fast. Does it make me fly? It doesn't make me fly. I don't feel faster. Nope. We are not going into that nightmare. Oh boy, that was a bad choice. was a dodge that was on purpose. Oh, that room looks terrifying. Let's see who we've got here. Looks like we lost Mystery Machine SA in chat. One thing I noticed talking with one of the guys at work is that this is basically the standard modern template for Magic cards. Apparently Lady Blair is a 7-9. Pretty sweet. For anybody watching this that doesn't know, I actually work in a shop that sells Magic cards for my normal day job when I'm not doing this. That's a lot of dudes. The same could be said about a shop that sells Magic cards. That's a lot of dudes. Ah, that's... yeah, Mr. Zombie, I'll just stand here and get owned. That's cool. Now, there is no way that painting's just a painting. The painting is totally a boss. No, it is just a painting. Bullet Odyssey. The Cellar Door games talk about all of the games that they've done before. I think I already read this one, though. And frequently those paintings are actually hellishly large bosses. So walking up to it and smacking it with a sword was an awesome idea. Nope. I might survive another room yet. Ugh. Should've double jumped. Oh god. I'm not gonna survive another room if I'm not real careful. Is there even a chest in here? No. Screw this room. Sweet. Hit points. I'm gonna have to go back down there and kill the guys for whatever they drop. Oh, that was dumb. Good thing I got the hit points first. Pyrite. Another pyrite. Come on. Another thing this game has in common with Dark Souls is the fact that every single enemy telegraphs whatever move they're gonna do, so patience and observation is rewarded, though you can't be quite as patient in this game as you can with Dark Souls. $38.85. Not a completely wasted run. I could probably get something out of it. Oh, boy. That was dumb. Spike text to the face. I don't remember if I hit any chests there. Hypochondriac, OCD, Barbarian Queen, Assassin with PAD. Man, I love PAD. It's a shame Assassin seems to kind of suck. Tempted to re-roll these guys, but I'll end up with, like, two upside-down Hokages and a dragon. I'm actually not sure what Hypochondriac does. I don't know if I've ever risked taking it. 3885, still can't upgrade damage. I don't know if I could upgrade spell damage. I guess I could. Potion up? No, not even close. Yeah, let's up the magic damage. I have enough coins to unlock anything that I just have sitting around. Not quite. I can unlock that and then put real bracers back on. Yeah, I got a feeling that there was going to be a new game mode of some sort when I was almost done with the game and saw how many slots I had yet to unlock in terms of equipment. Yeah.
idea how long it's going to be before I've unlocked everything there is to unlock in terms of gear. Down. Oh, these rooms. I get to the point where I think I've mastered the timing when I stupidly walk into a face full of flame. Let's try for it. Ah! Screwed it up. Yeah, that's a rune I'm not getting. And some damage I didn't need to take. And PAD would be nice now. I almost wish I'd taken the assassin. Well, that was a waste. Go back. I just gotta not get cocky. Okay, we can go down here. Okay. Oh my god, there's so much stuff. The chakrams, they do nothing! Oh god. I do not want to die in, like, the second room of the dungeon. And my shout didn't do anything. It's alright. I got a ton of hit points. We're gonna burn through them all in this frickin' room. And that chest did not have nearly enough in it to be worth all the effort I put into acquiring it. Oh boy, I gotta get the hell out of here. Glad I noticed that before the trap went off. Another diary room. Worthless. Oops. Ah, that pyrite healed. God, why am I so terrible? Left. Maybe I need to put the training wheels back on. I could probably down attack this guy. Or just do that. Just ignore him. This room is not a good choice. I don't see any chest in here on the map. Yeah, it was totally not worth, like, all my hit points. Oh god. Doesn't look like there's any guys who are gonna shoot through the scenery. Let's see if I can get this before I die. Alright. Did I get enough to do anything? I guess we'll find out. Baldness and nearsighted him. Another barbarian king. Yeah, let's try not to waste all those hit points this time. Oh, I have enough for damage up, though. That's nice. Especially considering that the barbs don't hit very hard. I think, come what may, this life is going to be my last one for tonight. If I stream anything else, I might do another run with Zim tonight. Unless one of the guys from the podcast is on or around and wishes to try some Saints Row co-op. That'd be pretty fun. Apologies if you just joined me and you're in chat. I have to alt-tab tonight, so I've been in and out of chat all night. Oh boy. Thank goodness for Stringer Crits. Because that was the worst plan ever for that guy. Ah, okay. That was dumb. stupid mistakes can I make in one hallway? No, I thought I was gonna one-shot the Plinky. Screw you, Plinky. He actually got me one more time as I was cursing him. Helps if you hit them with the pointy end of your sword, idiot. $13.61. This whole life is going to be wasted, and I'm going to be forced to do one more. Just out of frustration. Come on. Let's get that meat. I thought I was going to just take missiles to the face there. Nice crit. Alright. Don't reach me in time. I can't believe I screwed that up. That was a free rune. One basically should have said, pay attention, jackass. Oh God. Boy, 2684. I'm gonna get to one more treasure chest before I bite it on this life. Or not. Sir Judson the Fourth. Poor Sir Judson. Slain by a pyrite. I got enough, looks like I got enough coins for a, cancel. For some sort of upgrade for the next life. We're gonna reroll characters. Gigantism and Farsighted. Yeah, that's who I want to start my next game with, but I do think that I'm gonna quit out for the evening. And thank everybody who tuned in for asking some relevant questions and whatnot. Always appreciate to have a little bit of interaction with the chat. So that was a quick look at New Game Plus on Rogue Legacy. Definitely has a little bit of a difficulty spike, especially if you don't have the Grace Rune stacked. I only have one Grace Rune on. Happily, that was all I needed. So, until next time, I can be found, as always, on YouTube at DocStout76, here, of course, on Twitch, my channel's DocStout, and I can also be found with the 40 going on 14 guys. We're going to record a new podcast tomorrow. Our website is 40go14.com. Check it out. As always, follow me on Twitch, subscribe, like on FaceTube, all that good stuff. And if you would like to support your favorite podcasters and favorite streamers, if you use ad blocking software, just do us a favor and flip it off when you're on our sites, because that's how we're able to keep bringing this content to you. That's going to do it for me tonight. Thanks for showing up. I'm going to sign off. I'll talk to everybody later.